26 years is a long time. It's a quarter of a century. It's incredible, actually. Difficult to believe. I saw Riga in the summer, which is a game changer. It feels like a European city. It feels like a very open place and a very dynamic place. I think in the late 90s, I was just opening up, slowly. But I had a very, very beautiful time trying to find my footsteps, you know, from 26 years ago. In the year 1997, I was an exchange student at Jacek Zwitol's Music Academy. There was an exchange program between Luxembourg, Enschede in the Netherlands, and Riga in Latvia, the conservatories. A friend of mine, a pianist in fact, told me, "You have to go, it's going to be great." I think for him it was a very important time, so I just followed his steps. I think the most important part for me was, in fact, to live alone for the first time in my life. I was 15 years old and I arrived in post-Soviet Latvia, quite a gloomy place. I was staying just around the academy, Mercela Jela. I didn't have so much to do, except for, you know, practicing the piano, so that's exactly what I did. I was very inspired by my classmates and other students at the academy. I became very serious about the piano, just practicing and trying to give my best. I think without this spirit in my life, I would not be the pianist I am today, for the simple reason that when you're 15 years old, you have maybe a lot of stimuli and you want to do different things. But for me, I was just concentrating on one thing, and that was practicing the piano. Which got me into Juilliard in New York. In fact, I don't think I would have gotten into Juilliard if I didn't have my time in Riga. I did exactly what I felt was right. If that meant digging into electronic music or digging into some marginal composers of the classical repertoire, or in fact not playing most of the classical repertoire, I'm very lucky to have been able to continue in music and do exactly what I like in music. I think there are some careers, for the lack of a better word, in music where people may not be doing exactly what they want to do. But in my case, this was my freedom. That's something I am very adamant about. You know, I want to be very free in music. And so I want to be a pianist, but I didn't want to play most of the romantic repertoire. And then I wanted to be participating in the electronic music movement, but I wanted to play the piano. So those are the idiosyncrasies that are original, and maybe they are looked upon with some disdain or at least some skeptical feelings. But for me, it has worked out. And then the second aspect would be definitely the people that I have met throughout my journey. People, the mentors, the teachers, the professors, whom I accompanied in their journey, too. They were big inspirations. I have to mention my teacher in Riga at the Music Academy, Teofils Bicis. He passed away, I think, in 2000, but he definitely taught me a great, great deal of piano playing. So yeah, I owe a lot to Riga and to Latvia. To come back a quarter century later and to play my music was very rewarding, because at the time, of course, I was just a conservatory student and I was playing the classical repertoire. So I was very grateful to come back to Riga and to bring my own music, and meeting with my friends, my people, which was again very emotional. Anyways, it was a very, very beautiful trip and I will never forget.